Gonna build a mountain from a little hill.
Hey guys, and thank you so much for tuning into my channel. My name is The Lady Designer, and we are back with another episode of Inama Zoo. It's been a month, but as I said in a previous episode, we're getting back to Inama Zoo, but we're not going to like have a proper schedule or anything. So I'm going to squeeze an episode in every now and then. And here we are with another episode, which is for the cheetahs. So I'm really excited to add these animals because they're super beautiful. And I can't even remember, it has been super long since the last time I've added the cheetah. I think that was in Meilen Zoo. I'm not really sure if I ever had them in my franchise zoo. So I think Meilen Zoo, which is like last year probably, or beginning of this year. So it's been a really long time. But they're really amazing animals, and especially their cubs are just super adorable. So yeah, I'm just really happy that we're finally going to add the beautiful cheetahs in Inama Zoo. The cheetah lives more in a grassland savanna area in Africa, so I didn't want to go crazy in this habitat. I really wanted to make sure that they have this more plain open area, open field where they could run around, but I really soon noticed that it was a little bit too boring, so I decided to make a few tweaks and changes here and there. But as I said also in the previous episode, the reason why it took so long to get back to this series was really because I just wanted to go for a more realistic approach, and that kind of burned me out that I wasn't really sure anymore what I should do. So that's why I wanted to let go a little bit more of the realistic stuff. Obviously, we're still trying to approach a realistic habitat and stuff, but it's going to be less than like the plan when I started this series, because else I'm just don't really feeling it. So I'm just giving it a little bit of my own twist here and there, and also try to still have this kind of realistic approach to it. But I just feel like for me, it works way better to continue this series by letting that a little bit go. So we start off with the track. Like the track was first a little bit shorter. Like I obviously just put down a track to make sure that we had a track. And later on, when we do more detailing, we're going to plan out exactly where we want the track to be. So I wanted to make sure that the track is completely hidden away like we do in most of the areas. But yeah, at some point you can't really hide it that much away. So we're just gonna pretend that there is like a man-made bridge or anything like that. Or maybe I will try to hide it with some kind of man-made bridge in the end. But I do try to like draw out the track with, I think in this case, it's a little bit of a rock terrain painting. Just to give the idea of that, that is the track they always use to drive the jeeps around in this wildlife park. But yeah, I just in general just really love to have this more natural open feeling without seeing the tracks, so only having the jeep safari going around. The jeep safari is actually quite a thing because I'm pretty sure that it's a complete track right now, but for some reason it's giving me errors and I'm trying to not put too much attention to it. But I really wonder once I finish this if the track is even able to ride, because I don't know why I keep having all these problems. I tried to add another station to it, but it's still giving me issues. I tried to connect the station, so I don't know. I'm just gonna try and not pay attention too much to it right now. And once it's finished, I'm going to try and see if I can fix that in a later stage and make sure that we can have like a really cool ride, of course, of the whole safari ride. I think it's going to look really awesome. And if it's still not working, I'm just gonna send it to Frontier like, hey, I really have no idea what I did wrong. How can I make my track to work? I mean, they made the game, so I'm pretty sure that they can help out if it really keeps giving me errors. I don't know if anyone else has experience with that. Do let me know in the comment section down below if you know where there might be an issue. But obviously, I can imagine it's gonna be hard for you guys to see for my zoo what will be the issue. So don't bother too much about it. I think it's gonna be fine in the end. So what I really wanted to do with this habitat is I wanted to make sure that you don't see any fences. So the terrain is really high, or it is high comparing to the rest of the area. So you actually just have like this natural boundary with the terrain itself to make sure that the cheetah is not able to go down. And we have, unfortunately, those big door gates for the track, for the the separation between habitats. And I was actually working on those areas, like to hide it away that you don't really see super obvious that there are like these gates. And then I was like, oh, but wait, I use elephant grass now, so the cheetah is not able to go to the other side. And I almost deleted the gate until I realized, oh wait, it was not per se for these type of animals, but it was for the naughty warthogs and like the baby ostrich and those kind of animals that are able to get into the cheetah habitat. So I almost forgot about that and I almost deleted the doors again. Like, why am I having these doors? But that is to make sure that the warthogs and stuff are not able to go into the other habitat. So we're going to try and hide away these doors as much as possible from both sides, so you won't see them unless you go through them. So yeah, that's quite a challenge to make sure that the viewing is not being ruined or anything like that. But in the end of the day, I think it works just really well having these doors, yeah, as much hidden as possible. So as I said, I really wanted to make sure that this habitat wasn't like super plain and boring with grassland. So that's why I decided to have like this cave going underneath the track. Well, it's not really a cave, it's more of a tunnel, I guess. But it also provides a little bit of shelter for the cheetah, and it gives a little bit of like different height variations in the landscaping. And I think that is something we really needed in this habitat to really create a little bit more of an interesting environment, because else it would have been super boring. And obviously, I wanted to give it a little bit more green, so here and there I added some shrubs and some bushes and stuff, and a lot of trees, Acacia umbrella tree? I'm not really sure if that is a name, probably making a huge fool of myself, but you guys will see what kind of trees I mean, which I put down, because I don't know, I just feel like those trees are just super common in like these more grassland savanna areas, and I really just love how they look. And we use them a lot too in the other sections of the bigger habitat with the elephants and the hippos and the giraffes and stuff. So yeah, I think it's just really cool to have these type of trees again in this habitat too. But obviously, they're going to be more different habitats with a little bit more variations into it. So as much as I want to avoid like using enrichment items, I did use a few of them, like the zebra enrichment item, and the, I think, one pumpkin and a cart box and another toy they can play with. Because at the end of the day, I was thinking of Kowali Sue and how smart Mike was and Rudy to create the whole track and like make sure that whenever the track reaches a certain area that the animals were walking there. And in the end of the day, I want to have like a cool safari track ride that really works and you can actually see animals. Like, obviously you can do a lot when you make a video like, okay, I'm gonna make a tour out of the whole safari ride, I'm gonna cut every time there's no animal and gonna redo it again. But that's not what you want. You want to have a safari ride that works right from the start, that you at least can have one glimpse of each and every animal in every habitat ride. So yeah, that is at least the goal I'm going for, and hopefully that is going to work, because as I said, I can't really test the safari track ride at all, so we really have to wait and see how that will go down in the end of the day. So in the last episode, I did ask you guys for good climbers for the mountain area we're going to work on. So we have this beautiful waterfall mountain area where we're probably going to add the now monitors in that water section. I'm super excited to start working on that because I think that's going to look super beautiful. And on the outside, I want to have two different habitats. So I want to have the mountain actually split into two areas. And my idea was to have the okapi and the aardvarks there. And it is some people saying like, I can totally live with that. Like, I can tell why you would add those type of animals, and especially the okapi, as long as it's more of like a little bit more dense, foresty area for the okapi because they're pretty shy animals, so they do tend to like hide way more in between the bushes and stuff. So I think we're definitely going to add one animal on one side, the okapi. And on the other side, I had a few suggestions. I also had the mandrill, the gorilla, and the lions. But I'm actually planning to have those three animals on the other side of the wildlife park. So like the back of the hippo area. And I might even also squeeze in the flamingos on that side too. I really love that idea. But I also love the idea to have like a more rainforest area on that side, with like in between some kind of lake with the flamingos, and then you have like these peek throughs when you go through this rainforest with the Jeep Safari, and then you have this peek through the water section in the middle and seeing the flamingos. I'm not entirely sure yet where I'm going to add the flamingos, but yeah, the mandrill and the gorillas I definitely will want to add on that side of the wildlife park. So the other suggestions I had were the bungo, my favorite bungo of this game. I really love those guys. The derpy bungo face. I'm actually tended to just use the bungos again because the bungos are just my favorite. So with the okapi on the other side, or then the nyala or the springbok. I remember that we already spoke about the nyala earlier to add it in that region. So I'm still having a little bit of doubt if I'm going to add the derpy bungo face or the nyala, because the derpy bungo face is my favorite, but the nyala, I can't really remember that I ever added them in any zoo that we built so far. I don't think we did. So I think I should go for the nyala just because we never built a habitat for them. So yeah, I'm still a little bit in doubt. I don't know what you guys think. Do let me know in the comment section down below what you guys feel about that. So the last thing I wanted to point out was a question I got in the last episode was from Self-Aware Snow. And he or she asked, what keeps you entertained while playing Planet Zoo? Because you've been playing it for so long and it's all you make videos about, but you must do take some breaks from it, right? It made me giggle a little bit. Like, I do indeed play a lot of Planet Zoo. I am planning to do a little bit more variation on the channel really soon. But I obviously also sometimes feel that the game is burning me out a little bit. And sometimes you just need a break from it. And I think for me also really works to have different zoos. So I can sometimes say, okay, I'm a little bit burnt out in this zoo right now, so I'm just going to play another zoo. But it of course also happens for me that I sometimes don't touch the game for a few days, just because I'm like not really feeling it. Like sometimes it does work that you're like, you just start building somewhere and you get into it. But sometimes you're just really not feeling it. And forcing yourself to be creative is like the worst thing ever. So no, of course I take breaks. And of course I take some time for myself and do not get burned out of the game. But also including me, I also feel like we just need some new stuff in the game. So I am really ready for something else, even though I'm still surprised about myself that I keep building in all these zoos. But as long as I have fun, why not, I guess. So, but I'm curious how you guys feel about that, and if you ever feel like burnout of the game, and how you manage to get back into the game. I'm really, really curious how you guys work with that and deal with that. So do let me know in the comment section down below. So now with this video ending, I really hope you guys enjoyed. Do let me know in the comment section down below. Leave a like at video if you guys enjoyed. And subscribe, of course, if you haven't already. And if you want to support the channel a little extra, you may want to consider to become a FAFM member with the link down in the description. Thank you guys so much for watching. And I really hope to see you guys all in the next one. Bye guys!